If you have been desiring to start a business of your own, you may be grappling with the question of whether to do work you're familiar with, that's on your resume, or doing something completely different. So in this video, I'm going to share what to expect from these two types of leaps that I call the lateral leap and the faith leap. You're going to learn how to choose between the two and what to expect when it comes to building a business with each pathway when you choose the right one for you. Thanks so much for joining me today. I'm Lydia Lee, the work reinvention coach and solopreneur strategist at Screw the Cubicle. And over the years, I've helped hundreds of budding and existing business owners to build an intentional business that's designed from their genius zone so that they can truly experience freedom in their life and in their business. If you're new here, welcome. And don't forget to hit the subscribe or the notification bell button in order to be the first to know when new videos hit this channel every single month. There is no right or wrong pathway when it comes to planning out your self-employment plan. I personally have gone through the lateral leap and the faith leap, which I'm going to explain a little bit more in this video next up. But I just want you to start with understanding that your unique situation may call for a combination of both, or you might actually start at one type of pathway and continue on the same one and potentially even switch over later on. So for example, I transitioned with a very familiar skill set, right? In order to get out of the cubicle faster. It wasn't my forever career, but it was a good enough leap into helping me be self-employed and negotiate a consultancy with my old employer in order to start my entrepreneurship journey, and slowly but surely became a small agency and then did a side hustle, which is what you now know as Screw the Cubicle, my full-time business. And that took, you know, a year or so in the making. So know that you may transition to start with a familiar skill based on where you're at right now. This might feel right for you to get started, and then know that you're also going to grow into a new body of work as you start working for yourself. So it's not a permanent decision. You can change at any time. And also know that your work and your body of work will evolve as you evolve as a human, and to allow that to happen as it comes. So don't get too stuck on doing the perfect 100% right thing, because there's no such thing. We are only going to do what's sort of right for right now for all our lives. And the best way to get started is what's going to feel easier, what's going to feel most meaningful to the goals that you truly want for yourself right now. And perhaps, you know, this video, after I've explained both pathways, will allow you to make that choice more confidently. I also think another great video you should watch after this one is the one I filmed about the 3 tips to transition from a job to self-employment, where I offer a lot of my own mistakes and what I would have done differently in that video. So you can find that in the cards above to watch after this video. Okay, let's start with the first type of leap that I call the lateral leap, which is the first leap I took as well when I quit my job almost a decade ago. Now, a lateral leap is a type of leap that where you're using the skills that you've been probably paid to use before. So these are skills in your resume, in your corporate career, maybe even things like volunteer work where you haven't been paid, but you've got a ton of professional experience in that realm. And you may be considering using these skills. And likely you might be a lateral leaper if you like what you're doing at the moment. So you don't have any angst around performing these skills. Maybe you may not be happy in the environment you're working in. You're living at offices sometimes as well, right? We spend a lot of time in our jobs. And you may not like who you're working for or the type of company that you're with, but you do like the skill set that you do, and you want to continue doing it, right? So inside your heart, you feel that this is something you still want to pursue, just not in this context in a 9-to-5 job. So the great thing about lateral leaps is that it's probably the easiest type of leap to start, because you're already really confident in what it is that you can offer. And you can start making money with it right away, just like I did when I did my lateral leap, was remaining in the same industry, but just choosing a section of the industry, if you will, right? And not doing all the things that I used to do as the manager in my company, but doing one tiny portion and being a consultant, right? For example, right? That was my lateral leap, a consulting agency that allowed me to continue using my contacts, using the network, the social equity that I've already built in that industry. That's also a really good benefit for you. So if you're a lateral leaper, not only will you be confident in the skill sets that you have, which will therefore help you to launch faster and make money immediately, you can also leverage that social equity, all the networks, contacts, you know, colleagues, sweat in the game, if you will, right? However many years you've been in the industry. And that can be a great asset, right? To starting a business, because now you may have people you can pitch for your services right away that can vouch for your work and know your expertise really clearly, right? This may also be the leap you take if you are using it as a transition to do something different later on. But right now you need to make some money, you need to get out of your job, you wanna do something different, and you don't wanna wait till you sort of gain more experience in a different craft, and you're willing, right? That's the big word here, willing to utilize the skills you have currently in order to transition and build a freedom-based business, not working for other people. And then as you're building this business, you might be using it to fund, right? Something else that may not be as confident about, or something that you find purposeful to do but don't yet have experience doing. So that's exactly what I did as well. I wasn't a coach by trade, and I was still going through training and doing the deep work that I needed to do to become a good coach, but I didn't want to wait till that happened, right? So I used my corporate experience, made a lateral leap transition, became a business owner, and then worked on my more forever business on the side, right? That might be something that you might be finding meaningful to do also. Now, the thing about lateral leaps is the focus is not to do exactly what you used to do in corporate, because then it'll be too much, right? And you won't be specialized, because the great thing that people love about you when you're in corporate is you're able to put on multiple different hats. But as an entrepreneur, actually having a boundary of work to be specialized in a particular area of work is going to allow you to be more successful. So that's what I did as well, is to specialize in a particular area in my industry, be known for that, and start pitching for clients, which allowed me to land more clients that needed that particular service more often. So if you are taking a lateral leap, make sure that you list all the things you know how to do, have a bit of reflection about what parts of the work you most enjoy and can create the most impact around, right? And create services and packages and offers that have boundaries, okay? And very specific, so that you can be a specialized consultant, contractor, freelancer, rather than a generalist, which is gonna be easier for you to market your work. Now, I filmed a video all about how to package your offer as a coach or a consultant that you might wanna check out after this video as well, that I'm gonna put in the cards above, that I think will be really helpful in finding your unique way, right, of packaging your experience into a coaching or consulting offer. The second type of leap is what I call a faith leap. And a faith leap is doing something different that you've never done before when it comes to making money around it. But you might be using some, what I call the, you know, school of hard knocks, right? Using real world experience, where you may have solved a problem for yourself personally, or done something that you've never been paid to do, but you do it in real life, right? And you want to build a business around that concept or that idea or that offering of transformation for others. Now, this may be something that you have in your mind and may be afraid to launch because you are believing that until you have professional experience, you're not really allowed to make money from it. But there is a way to think about this differently so that you can feel confident about it, which I'm going to talk about more, right? But you are a faith leaper if you believe that you no longer perhaps want to do exactly what you used to do on your resume or what you've done on your resume. Maybe you use some different skill sets in your suite of skills towards your business, but the idea or what it is that you want to help people do in a business is going to be something you've done in maybe your personal life rather than a professional life, right? Through the Cubicle, for example, my business is a faith leap business, or was a faith leap business. I didn't start with that right away, but it was my intention to grow into that business while I was having my lateral leap business fund me first, right? So you can start it like I did, or you can go straight to a faith leap, actually. And if that's the thing you want to start with, that's a personal choice that you get to make. And know that there's going to be a different pathway of how you launch this business, right? So you might choose to do a faith leap type of pathway to a business if you believe that you have real life experience that's been really meaningful for you to have gone through. You feel like you're talking about all the stuff you've learned with people you meet, your friends and family. You're probably giving free advice at the moment to other people. And every time you talk about this topic, you help someone through it, paid or unpaid, you feel purposeful. You're like, this kind of feels like the work I want to pursue, right? And you are willing to gain experience and take the time to validate that this work is going to work for others. Just because it's worked for us doesn't mean it's exactly how it's going to work for others. So as a faith leaper, your deep work to launch this business is going to require you to focus on testing with real humans and working with real people to gain that experience, right? A little different from the lateral leaper that I talked about previously, where they already have these years of experience, they've been validated by getting paid. And so now you're going to have to validate yourself as well by taking some due diligence to actually work with some people face-to-face, right? Work with some real problems, maybe complementary to start, or using a case study, right, to ensure that the steps you took to solve this problem for yourself is actually going to work for others as well, right? Beta testing that experience with humans is going to allow you to gain internship, right? That you are, it's not going to be your first rodeo if you launch this offer or this business. You're going to have some backing and evidence of creating results by working with real people, right? In order to do that. So beta testing is really important. I talk about beta testing a lot with on this channel, and certainly a big portion of what I teach my students to be able to launch confidently. Both lateral leapers and faith leapers will need to go through a beta test to get testimonials, to get validation for their offers, and feel confident in delivering that work before they officially launch, right? But more so for faith leapers who are gaining experience for the first time. But all in all, you can do it if that is what it is that you want. So if you haven't watched my video on how to validate and test your ideas before you launch, whether you're a lateral leaper or a faith leaper, you might want to check out my video above on exactly this, how to beta test with real humans to be able to validate your business idea before you launch. Well, now that you've heard a little bit about what a lateral leap pathway looks like compared to a faith leap pathway, I would love to hear from you. Which type of leap is most aligned with what it is that you may want to experience when you take the leap out of your corporate job, your cubicle, and to work for yourself, right? Which one may you want to start with that's going to feel like the path of least resistance, or is going to feel like the path of most meaning for you? There's no right or wrong answer. It's just what's right for you. I would love for you to share it with me in the comments below and let me know whether a lateral leap or a faith leap is the one that you want to start with, and what's that business that's going to allow you to take that leap of faith, or a leap, a lateral leap of familiarity that's going to get you started and going in your business. Let me know. I would love to read it. And if this video has been helpful for you in discerning that question on whether to do something familiar or to strike out and do something different, please share it with someone else that might be grappling with this question, that might be able to discern this for themselves by watching it. Make sure to like the video so that more people on the internet can find this video. And of course, please subscribe if you haven't done so already, so that you can get the newest video that I'm going to release this month, and be able to join me on the adventure as we go through, the wonderful world of launching businesses, but doing it meaningfully and intentionally. Thank you so very much for joining me, and I can't wait to see you on our next video.